In this video, we'll show you ways of organizing the elements in your scene in Maya using the closest equivalents to Softimage's groups and layers. In the previous video, we looked at what groups are in Maya, but let's go back to what groups are in Softimage. They're versatile organizational units that you can use for many things, such as selection, assigning properties and shaders, and attaching materials and textures. You can also set the selectability and different types of visibility on the group members. There's no single organizing element in Maya like a Softimage group, but you can use sets for different things. There are many types of sets in Maya, such as character sets containing objects for animation, like Softimage's character key sets, UV sets containing different UV arrangements for multiple textures on an object, and selection sets, which we'll look at here. These sets are collections of any type of object, component, or scene element that you want to select in one shot. For example, you could create a set for things like all skin deformer objects, the same as you create a group of envelope deformers in Softimage, or create sets of vertices or faces on the skin, as you would create point or polygon clusters in Softimage. Here, we'll select only the closed upright books on the top shelf, which are all in groups, and choose Create Sets Quick Select Set to create a set for them. You can also create an icon for the set on a shelf for easy access. The set is a separate node that represents the collection, and you can see it and its members in the outliner. Sets are at the scene level and can't be part of a hierarchy. To select the members, select the set and press the down arrow key. You'll notice that the members are highlighted in their original structure as well. You can also select the members by choosing the set from the Edit Quick Select Sets menu, or click its icon on the shelf. An object or component can be a member of more than one set. All the upright books are also members of a set that contains all the books in the scene. You can control the membership of a set using the Relationship Editor. Make sure that Set Editing is selected at the top, and then select the set that you want to edit in the left panel. In the right panel, click the object you want to add to the set. If the object is already part of the set, clicking it removes it from the set. You could also highlight items in the set and choose Edit Remove Highlighted from Set. Note that highlighting objects in the panels doesn't actually select them in the scene, unless you choose Edit Select Highlighted from either panel. In this editor, you can also create nested sets. On the left panel, select the set to which you want to add other sets. And in the right panel, click the set that you want to be nested under the other set. To delete a set from this editor, click it and choose Edit Delete Highlighted. Or simply select it in the outliner and press the Delete key. Only the set is deleted, but its members remain where they are in the scene. Note that you can middle-click and drag nodes to add them to a set, but if you do this to remove them from the set, their original membership in a group or hierarchy is affected. Instead of using sets for controlling the selectability and visibility of objects in Maya, you use layers, the same as you can do in Softimage. To create a layer, you can select objects and click this icon, or choose Layers, Create Layer from Selected. You can also create an empty layer by choosing Layers, Create Empty Layer, or click this icon. Then select the object and right-click the layer and choose Add Selected Objects. Double-click the layer name or click the little icon next to the name to open the Edit Layer box, where you can give it a more descriptive name. If you want to color code a layer, select an index color or choose RGB and create or pick a custom color. In wireframe view, the objects in this layer take on its color, which is rather handy. You can change the order of a layer in the list by middle mouse dragging it up or down, or by clicking the icons above. You can add selected objects to any layer, but an object can be in only one layer at a time. If you add them to another layer, they're removed from the previous one. To remove objects from a layer, select them, then right-click on the layer and choose Remove Selected Objects. Another way to manage which objects are in a layer is to choose Layers Membership to open the Relationship Editor. You can add objects to or remove them from the layers as you did with the selection sets. To toggle the visibility of objects in a layer, click the first cell. Click the second cell until a T appears to show a templated or ghosted image of the objects in this layer. Templating the layer makes those objects unselectable, and you can't snap objects to them either. If you click this cell until an R appears, it makes the objects referenced. Referenced objects remain in whatever display mode you're using, but they're unselectable. However, you can snap objects to them. Remember that a referenced object looks normal, so if you can't seem to select it, check if it's in a layer that's referenced. When this cell is empty, it means that the objects in the layer are selectable. To delete a selected layer, right-click it and choose Delete Layer. This, of course, deletes the layer itself, but not the objects in it. In the next video, we'll look at ways of organizing Maya scene elements for sharing them between scenes.